ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், பராசர பட்டர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். வி ஆர் சீயிங் தி மீனிங்ஸ் ஃபார் தி டிவைன் நேம்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணா பேஸ்ட் ஆன் ஸ்ரீ விஷ்ணு சஹஸ்ரநாமம் விச் இஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் மகாபாரதம். With the help of the simple Tamil explanation given by Kanchipuram Prativadi Bhayankaram Annangaracharya Swami, we are going through the meanings in English. We have completed up to 850th name. We will continue from 851st name. Now we are enjoying Bhagavan's auspicious qualities, which relate to how he helps others. Previously we saw many different names which relate to his incarnations, and then we saw the names which relate to the Ashtasiddhi, how Bhagavan has Ashtasiddhi readily in him. Now we are continuing on with enjoying his special qualities. 851st name is Bharabhrithu. Bharabhrithu means one who carries the burden of Chetanas, all the living beings, all the souls, Atmas, conscious beings, their Yogam and Shemam. That is, their well-being is maintained by Bhagavan. Yogam is preserving what is already there. Shemam is bringing new happiness, new joy. Both of these are done by Bhagavan. That is explained in this name, Bharabhrithu. 852nd name is Kathitaha. Kathitaha means one who is praised, hailed in Shastram to be having all auspicious qualities in full. All of the Shastram praise Bhagavan, glorify Emperor as having many, many innumerable auspicious qualities. That effect is explained in this name, Kathitaha. 853rd name is Yogihi. Yogi means two things are joined. Here, the aspect of Agatita Ghatana Samarthyam. Agatita Ghatana Samarthyam means joining two contrary things, making them coexist. That greatness is present in Bhagavan. We have seen this even previously. For example, Bhagavan is having many contrary qualities within him. Darkness is an aspect, light is an aspect. Both are present in Bhagavan. Everything is present in Bhagavan. So naturally, opposite qualities will also be present, opposite aspects will also be present in Bhagavan. And he maintains them, he has them coexist in himself without any contradictions. Even his aspect of consuming the whole cosmos, material realm, and resting in the causal ocean in a small people leaf, in a very small form. So he consumed the whole cosmos, yet he is having a very small baby form, Krishna form. And he is resting on this people leaf. So such qualities, such quality of keeping contradictory aspects in him is explained in this name, Yogi. 854th name is Yogishaha. Yogishaha means one who is the master of great yogis like Sanaka, Sanandana, there are many sages. These are, for example, the four Manasaputras of Brahma who are fully focused on Brahmanubhavam. They are great yogis. So their yogam is conducted by Bhagavan, fulfilled by Bhagavan. So Yogishaha means one who fulfills the yogam of great yogis. 855th name is Sarvakamadaha. Sarvakamadaha means one who gives all desires, grants all desires. So here, those who are taking up yoga, yoga is the process of bringing the mind, body and soul together in harmony and focusing all of that in Bhagavan. So even for those who failed in this process of yoga, Bhagavan out of his mercy gives the Ashtasiddhis, starting with Anima, Mahima and so on. We have already seen how Bhagavan already has those aspects in him. So Bhagavan can bestow, grant these siddhis to those yogis, even to those yogis who failed. So he is known as Sarvakamadaha, one who fulfills all desires, one who grants all desires. 856th name is Ashramaha. Ashramaha means one who eliminates all the fatigue, all the tiredness, all the tapam in this material world. That quality is present in Bhagavan to eliminate all of that. That is why he is known as Ashramaha. 857th name is Shramanaha. Shramanaha means one who makes yogis to continue from wherever they left in their previous lives. So a yogi may start practicing yogam and may even make progress, but at some point he may die without completing his yogam, without attaining fulfillment in it. It is Bhagavan who makes such person continue that yogam in the next life easily. So he gives that ability to that person. Hence he is known as Shramanaha. 858th name is Kshamaha. Kshamaha means even the yoga brashtas, those who failed in yogam, if they start meditating upon Bhagavan, Bhagavan can liberate them and make them muktas, muktatmas. So he is known as Kshamaha. 859th name is Suparnaha. Related to the previous name, Suparnaha means one who can facilitate, help those who are desirous to cross this ocean of samsara, nescience, and make them reach the other shore, which is Vaikuntham, Paramapadam. This quality is present in Bhagavan. Even in Bhagavad Gita, he says, Daivi Hayesha Gunamayi Mama Maya Duratyaya Mameveye Prapadyante Maya Metham Tarantite. Only those who are surrendered at my lotus feet, they will be able to cross the ocean of samsara. Otherwise, it is very difficult to cross, he says. So such quality is highlighted here in this name, Suparnaha. 860th name is Vayuvahanaha. Vayuvahanaha means one who has Garuda as his vehicle. And with that, even those who fall deep in samsara, Bhagavan is able to reach out to them and lift them up. That is why he is known as Vayu Vahanaha. 861st name, Dhanurdharaha. It is well known that Bhagavan has the bow, Saranga. This Sarangam is the main bow of Bhagavan. And because of his control over this bow, he can easily win anyone. He has full control over this bow. That is why he is known as Dhanurdharaha. 862nd name is Dhanurvedaha. Dhanurvedaha means one who is the teacher for the skill of using bows. So he is the main propagator of this particular skill, of this particular stream of knowledge of using bow and arrow. Archery, basically. That is Dhanurvedaha. 863rd name is Dandaha. Dandaha means one who punishes through kings. In those days, the kings were seen as representatives of Bhagavan, especially the just kings, the kings who were following Dharma properly. And such kings would punish the offenders, those who commit mistakes. And it is Bhagavan who is working through the kings to punish them and to reform them. Hence, he is known as Dandaha. 864th name, Damayitaha. Damayitaha means Bhagavan also punishes directly in person. Just as he punished Ravana, he punished Hiranyakashipu, he punished Hiranyaksha. So many evil persons were directly punished by Bhagavan also. Depending on the gravity of the mistake performed by the individual, Bhagavan either punishes them through the kings or he punishes them directly. Because he punishes them directly, he is known as Damayita. 865th name is Adamaha. Adama means one who is not controlled by anyone. He is beyond the control of any individual. He is purely independent, supremely independent, and nobody can control him naturally. That quality is explained in the name Adamaha. Next, 866th name, Aparajitaha. Aparajitaha means he makes orders, rules. These orders are never overruled or blocked by anyone at any time, at any place. When he makes a particular order, it is final. Such quality is known as Aparajita. 867th name, Sarvasaha. Sarvasaha means one who carries everyone. Devas, Manishyas, Tiryak, Stavara. Celestial beings, human beings, animals, plants, birds, everything is supported by Bhagavan. That quality is known as Sarvasaha. 868th name, Niyantaha. Niyanta means one who conducts and controls even those who are faithful towards other devatas. Even if someone is faithful towards other devata, all the devatas are appointed by Bhagavan to conduct the world properly. So So even if someone has faith in such devata, Bhagavan conducts them as per their desire. By being the antaryami, the indwelling super soul of the devata, as well as the individual who is following the devata. That is Niyanta. 869th name, Niyamaha. Niyamaha means, through the other devatas, Bhagavan grants them the desires. That is, he grants those who pray to such other devatas, through those devatas themselves, Bhagavan grants their desires. This way they remain faithful and progress spiritually as well. Hence, he is known as Niyamaha. 870th name is Yamaha. Yama means one who grants certain privileges, certain abilities to all the devatas and let them also act and do some controlling. So they are given some powers and they are allowed by Bhagavan to enact such powers, whatever they have. Hence he is known as Yama. 871st name is Sattvavan. Sattvavan means one who has Shuddha Sattva Gunam. One who has pure goodness, which is beyond the goodness which you see in this material world. Bhagavan has Shuddha Sattvam, which is totally free from any rajas or tamas. In the material world, sattvam is mixed with rajas and tamas. We see somebody who is very generous, he gives a lot of charity. But the same person may also become angry, may also hold certain things and does not give to others. So at some point he may be in goodness, other times he may be in passion or ignorance. But Bhagavan, on the other hand, has Shuddha Sattvam, which means he is always in the mode of pure goodness. 872nd name is Sattvikaha. Sattvikaha means one who can grant the results for having Sattvagunam. So if someone has Sattvagunam, goodness, they get some results as part of their acts. It is Bhagavan who bestows such results. The results may include dharma, that is the concept of righteousness developing in the individual, jnanam, knowledge developing in the individual, vairagyam, detachment developing in the individual. All of these are results of having sattvagunam. It is Bhagavan who grants such results. 873rd name is Satyaha. Satyaha means one who is fixed in truth. Bhagavan is always truthful. He is always in the side of truth. He stands along with the truthful persons. Hence he is known as Satyaha. He always stands with the noble devotees. 874th name, Satyadharma Parayanaha. Satyadharma Parayanaha means the Sattvikas, that is the good people, the noble people, whatever righteousness they do, Bhagavan accepts them with joy, with love. Hence he is known as Satyadharma Parayanaha. 875th name is Abhiprayaha. Abhiprayaha means, by such noble people, which we saw previously, Bhagavan is considered as the ultimate goal, ultimate result. this aspect of being thought about noble people as the ultimate goal is called as Abhipraya. 876th name, Priyarhaha. Priyarha means, Priya means those who are dear. So Bhagavan very much likes the jnanis, the pure devotees. And he is the apt one who can bless such dear devotees. Hence, he is known as Priyarhaha, one who is apt for the jnanis. 877th name, Arhaha. Arhaha means one who is aptly worshipable by jnanis. In the previous name, we saw that he is the one who can aptly bless jnanis. In this name, we are saying that Bhagavan is aptly worshipable by jnanis. 878th name, Priyakrithu. Priyakrithu means one who makes even those who are desirous of worldly pleasures to desire for him in the end. So he facilitates that process of changing a materialistic person to a very dear devotee who only seeks Bhagavan. This quality of Bhagavan makes him to be called as Priyakrithu. 879th name is Preeti Vardhanaha. Preeti Vardhanaha means Preeti, we all know, desire, love. Vardhana means increasing it. So here Bhagavan is the one who increases the love of his devotees towards him. The bhakti of his bhaktas are developed, nurtured by Bhagavan. Hence he is known as Preeti Vardhana. 880th name is Vihaya Sagatihi. Bhagavan is the means for his devotees to reach Paramapadam, Sri Vaikuntham. He is the direct means for his devotees. Now, this aspect is further explained in the subsequent names in context of Archiradi Gati. It is said that when a soul is destined to go to Sri Vaikuntham, Paramapadam, from this material world, after shedding the body, it goes through the Archiradi Margam, the path, the route, starting with the layer called Archis. This is the layer of light. And then from there onwards, it goes through many layers. And we are going to see all of them. And here, in these upcoming names, Bhagavan is explained as each of those layers. That is, he is being the facilitator in each of these layers for the Atma to go through these layers and reach Paramapadam in the end. 881st name, Jyotihi. Jyoti is light. So here, Bhagavan himself is the first step in this Archiradi Gati, Archiradi Margam, which is Archis, the layer of Archis, the layer of light. 882nd name, Suruchihi. This is the second layer, which is day, the representative of day, which is again bright time. So this is the second layer, and Bhagavan is this second layer as well. 883rd name is Hutabhug Vibhu. This represents the layer of Chandra. That too, the Shukla Paksha. Shukla Paksha is the period of waxing. And there is a layer which represents this waxing of the moon. And Bhagavan is being this layer as well. Here, the Chandra, the moon, is considered to be Amrita, considered to be consuming the things which are offered in Havis, which are treated as Amrit by Chandra, and it is consumed. They are consumed by Chandra, and it is said to be waxing. And this waxing period has a representative layer in this Achiradi Margam, that is Shukla Paksham, and this is the third layer, and Bhagavan is explained as this layer as well. 884th name is Uttarayana. This is the fourth layer of Achiradi, because in this Uttarayana time, Surya is shining brightly, and hence this Uttarayana period, the 6 months period, starting from mid-January, going up to mid-July, this period is considered to be Uttarayana, and it's considered to be very auspicious. And there is a layer representing Uttarayana in this Achiradi Margam, that is the fourth layer, Uttarayana layer, and that is also Bhagavan. 885th name is Virochanaha. This is the fifth layer in Achiradi Margam. This is called as Samvatsara. Samvatsara means year generally. The year has two ayanams, 2 6 months period. There is Uttarayanam, we just saw mid-January to mid-July, and then mid-July to mid-January again is called as Dakshinayanam. So the chariot of Surya is said to be traveling through this Uttarayana and Dakshinayana, and that gives us 1 year. And that is the layer, the fifth layer is the representative for that year, Samvatsara. And Bhagavan is also having this layer as his form, and hence facilitates the Atma to go one more, to cross one more layer. 886th name is Suryaha. Suryaha represents the Vayu Lokam here. Vayu Lokam is the sixth layer in Achiradi Gati. And Bhagavan is this layer as well, and hence he facilitates the Atma to cross over to the next layer. 887th name is Savitaha. Savita means it represents Surya. So Surya is the seventh layer in Achiradi Marga, because he facilitates rain, and because of rain the crop is created. He has special significance, and he is known as Savita, and this is the representative layer for Surya, and it is the seventh layer in this Achiradi Marga, and Bhagavan facilitates the Atma cross the seventh layer as well. 888th name is Ravilochanaha. This represents three layers in the Achiradi Marga, which is eighth layer is Chandra, representing moon, and then there is Vidyut, which is lightning, which has a particular layer representing in the Achiradi Marga, and then there is Varuna. There is the Varuna layer. Varuna is the devata for rain. So it's Surya who is giving light for Chandra, lightning, and then Varuna as well. So from Surya, one goes through these three layers, Chandra, and then Vidyut, the lightning layer, and then Varuna layer. And hence, Bhagavan is known as Ravilochanaha. So these three layers in this Apsaradi Marga are also explained here. Next is 889th name is Anantahuta Bhukbhokta. So here it is explaining greatly capable, having great glories, that is Indra and Brahma. Their two representative layers are highlighted here. So Indra is the, Indra's representation is the 10th layer, and Brahma's representation is the 11th. Indra's is 11th layer and Brahma's is the 12th layer, and Bhagavan is having these as also as his forms, and hence he facilitates the Atma go through two more layers in reaching Paramapadam. Sukkadaha, this is 890th name. This layer is the layer of Amanava. Amanava is a special devata who helps the Atma go from the material world into the spiritual world, into Vaikuntham. So this is the last layer. Amanava's layer is the last layer. This is the 13th layer in this Archiradi Marga. He is a very special personality. When he touches the Atma, all the traces of samsara gets removed from the Atma. Even while the Atma is traversing through these Archiradi layers, he has the Shukshma Sharira with him, which carries certain traces of samsara. But when Amanava touches the Atma, all the traces of materialistic world gets eliminated from the Atma. And then Amanava leads the Atma to the Viraja river, where the Atma takes a dip and comes out in the other side with a divine form. And then finally, the Atma is welcomed by the Nityasuris, Muktas, and then taken into the spiritual realm, which is Vaikuntham. And that's what we are going to see in the next set of names. 891st name, Naikadaha. The Mukta who crossed over Viraja river and attained a divine form is now welcomed by many apsaras. Apsaras are divine damsels, ladies who are servants of Bhagavan. They all come and decorate this Atma who entered Vaikuntham now, and they take this Atma to Bhagavan, to be with Bhagavan and eternally serve him. That is Naikadaha. 892nd name is Agrajaha. Agrajaha means one who is very blissful, one who is explained in Paryanka Vidya, which is a particular part of the Shastram, where Bhagavan is explained to be seated in this beautiful Adishesha throne, surrounded by Muktas and Nityasuris, and fully engaged in enjoying all the Atmas there. So he is full of opulence, he is full of bliss, and this quality is explained in this name, Agrajaha. 893rd name is Anirvinnaha. Anirvinnaha means After liberating this Atma in this manner, carrying him from the Archis layer up to the final layer of Amanavas layer, and then facilitating him to cross over the Viraja and getting him decorated at the entrance of Vaikuntham, and then finally having the Atma with him, he becomes free of sorrow for that particular Atma. Until then he is worried for that particular Chetana. Why is this Chetana, why is this Atma suffering in this material world while there is so much to enjoy in this spiritual world? So one more person gets liberated and Bhagavan becomes free from his anguish for that particular Atma. That is Anirvana. 894th name is Sadamarshi. Sadamarshi means from that time onwards Bhagavan accepts all the services, kaikaryams of that Muktatma eternally without any break. So Bhagavan can deal with innumerable Atmas at the same time. He can accept service from many, many persons at the same time. So once the person becomes liberated and he reaches Bhagavan, he starts serving. This is called as Sayujya Moksham. To be with Bhagavan, to be united with Bhagavan and to be serving him all the time. And this happens eternally, forever. Because Shastram says, Nachapuna Ravartate, once a person reaches Vaikuntham, there is no return for that person to material world. So it is Bhagavan who is blissfully accepting the service of such liberated person, and the liberated Atma too gets joyful by constantly serving Bhagavan. This aspect is explained in this name, Sadamarshi. 895th name is Lokadishtanam. Lokadishtanam means one who is the support for all the upper worlds. The spiritual realm is supported by Bhagavan, just as the material realm is supported by Bhagavan. 896th name is Adbhutaha. Adbhutaha means one who is so amazing that if we see him, we will think that we have never seen anything like Bhagavan before. We will be so amazed by seeing him. That is the amazing aspect in him, and hence he is known as Adbhuta. This name is also said to be Adbhutam, it seems. 897th name, Sanat. Sanat means one who is shared by all the Muktatmas. As we saw before, it is not that he is exclusive to anyone in Vaikuntham. He is equally enjoyable, equally approachable and equally enjoyable by all the Muktatmas, all the Nityasuris. So he presents himself to everyone so that everyone can collectively as well as individually serve him and enjoy him. 898th name is Sanatana Tamaha. Though he is present all the time, though he is enjoyed all the time by all the Atmas, yet every moment he looks fresh. He looks like a newly formed nectar. Appozhudhu kappozhudhu en aaraamudame, says Aalvar. That means every time Namalvar looks at Bhagavan, he looks new, he looks fresh. Bhagavan shows some new quality, new feature to Aalvar. So this is the special salient feature of Bhagavan, remaining fresh and remaining enjoyable every moment as new. 899th name is Kapilaha. Kapilaha means he is so shining, he is splendorously shining in the midst of Nityabhuti. Nityabhuti is Paramapadam, eternal real, spiritual real. Just as a cloud will shine beautifully because of a lightning. Cloud is dark in color, lightning is bright in color. Similarly, this Paramapadam, Vaikuntham, is very bright, very luminous. In the midst of it, Bhagavan is in dark complexion and shining greatly. Hence, he is known as Kapilaha. 900th name is Kapiravyayaha. Avyayaha Kapihi, that means one who constantly enjoys bliss, which is also eternal. He preserves such bliss and he enjoys that bliss always, without any break, without any reduction. So this concept is explained as Kapiravyayaha. Bhagavan is the continuous enjoyer of eternal bliss. This brings us to the end of the 9th centum. With this, we will stop today and then we will continue next time. ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், பராசர பட்டர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், காஞ்சிபுரம் பிரதிவாதி பயங்கர அண்ணங்கராச்சாரியார் திருவடிகளே சரணம்.
பிளீஸ் டவுன்லோட் ஆர் கோயில் KOYIL ஆப் ஃப்ரம் கூகுள் பிளே ஸ்டோர் ஆர் ஆப்பிள் ஆப் ஸ்டோர் டு லிசன் டு ஆர் டவுன்லோட் உபன்யாசம்ஸ் லைக் தீஸ். ஆர் வெப்சைட் போர்ட்டல் இஸ் KOYIL.org, koyil.org.